Hello, it's Douglas. I'm so thrilled to have you join us for another exciting episode on this channel. If you are new here, a warm welcome to you. But before we dive in, let me ask you a quick favor. Could you tap that like button? And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, and lastly make sure to turn on the notification bell. That way you won't miss any of the exciting videos. Alright, let's get started. Anonymity, or staying anonymous, refers to the state of remaining unidentified or untraceable while engaging in online activities. It's the shield that hackers wield to protect their identity and actions from prying eyes. Anonymity is a crucial tool for hackers as it allows them to operate discreetly, safeguarding their true identity and minimizing the risks of being traced back to their actions. Now, let's explore how virtual machines contribute to this essential aspect of the hacking and anonymity. First things first, let's break down the concept of virtual machines. Imagine having a computer within your computer. Sounds like magic, right? Well, it's real, and it's incredibly useful for a hacker's anonymity goals. Using virtual machines help provide an additional layer of security and makes it hard for prying eyes and malicious hackers, providing privacy and improving security. This is so crucial for you in your cybersecurity journey. By the end of this video, I will show you how to install and set up your first virtual machine and also install Kali Linux, our hacking environment. You can follow along by selecting a chapter specific to what you need. A virtual machine, or VM, is a software-based simulation of a physical computer. It's like having a separate operating system running inside your main one. A VM allows you to create isolated environments where we can experiment, run different operating systems, and keep our activities separate from our host system or main systems. Why use a virtual machine? Well, it's like a sandbox where you can play, experiment, and even mess up without damaging your main system. Perfect for hacking, right? To get started, we need a virtualization platform. In this episode, we're using Oracle VirtualBox, a popular choice for setting up virtual machines. It is a free and open source software compared to others. You can download the latest version compatible with your system for free from their official website. The website link is in the description. So I will go ahead and download the Windows version because my system is Windows. Once the download is complete, follow the installation wizard. It's pretty straightforward, just click next, 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 you know the drill. Make sure to double check any options related to network settings to ensure our virtual machine remains hidden. Now, because I already had VirtualBox 6.1 version installed and Kali Linux running, I will get these error messages, but I will just go ahead and close the running programs and then click retry. Wait for the installation to finish and launch the application. Next, we need to download Kali Linux. This is a Linux distribution for hackers and penetration testers. We shall be using it here a lot. You should know this already if you watched my roadmap video, and if you are just getting started with cybersecurity, consider watching it. Head to the official website. The link is in the description. Download the free latest ISO file, installer images compatible to your system. Mine is 64-bit, but yours could be 32-bit or Apple Silicon, and I'm downloading this in 2023. If you're watching this in 2025, get the latest version of 2025 too. Let the file download and save it to your system. Back to VirtualBox, let's create our virtual machine. You can see I already had one I've been using for years. I just upgraded the VM, but for your case, click on New to start the wizard. This opens up a new window with Expert Mode. If you're just creating a VM for the first time, it opens up a window where you will have to still select Expert Mode and not Guided Mode. Give your VM a name, I'll call mine CyberWiz. Choose the operating system. For our case, it's Linux, and the version is not Fedora or any of these, it's Debian 64-bit, skip this and click Hardware. Set the base memory, or RAM, I recommend at least 2 GB for a smooth experience. But if you plan to use Kali Linux for more advanced tasks, I recommend you locate at least 4 GB as long as it does not exceed the red line. Extend this to use at least 2 or more CPU, but don't exceed the red line either. Then you can check this, enable EFI, if your BIOS mode is UEFI and not legacy. Next, we create a virtual hard disk. Choose, create a virtual hard disk now, and then the file location and size. You can change the location, but I will leave mine to the default. Select the memory size. The default is 20 GB, but once again you can change it to at least 40 GB for improved performance. It's your choice according to your hardware capabilities. When done, click Finish to create the VM. Before we start Kali Linux installation, did you notice we did not load the ISO file we downloaded? To fix this, just click on Settings, then navigate Storage. You can see the IDE is empty. Go ahead and locate the ISO file from the Attributes frame. When done, also change the Network Settings to Bridged Adapter to connect the VM directly to the host machine. You can go ahead and change Display and other settings. This is optional. When done, click OK to apply the changes. You can now see the ISO is now loaded and the VM is now ready. To start installing our hacking environment, click Start to load this kind of a window, then you simply hit Enter to select the graphical install. And not any of these other options. A setup configuration is loaded, select your language, location, configure your keyboard. And hit Continue at every step. Wait for the installer components to load, the network configuration. These should happen along automatically. And if you get an option to set the clock too, do that please. Next, enter a desired host name. I will leave mine as Kali. But you can modify this, by the way. Choose a username. I will set mine as CyberWiz, an account name as CyberWiz, and next you choose a strong password you will recall, cause you will need this for every initial login and not the defaults of Kali, or root tour, if you know what I'm talking about. This is the most important part. Partitioning. Just use the guided mode partitioning to avoid any errors. Click all files in one partition, finish and write, and select yes here. The rest of the steps will just load and take some time, by the way. Let the install base system load, and the rest. Then when it comes to software selection, you can leave this to default. As you can see, it won't affect your system if you've got the proper hardware requirements in the first place. And then when it comes to grub boot loader and you get this kind of a message, make sure you select the boot loader and click yes. Do not continue without a bootloader. Then you can continue with the installation. Wait for the finish the installation to load. It will take some time off course, but just keep patient. Well, that took me a couple of minutes, damn. Comment down how many minutes it took for it to completely load on your side. After this, we now have our hacking environment ready. It will boot again and you will enter your username and password to login, not any other. And there it is. Our hacking machine inside another machine. Well, if you're still having difficulties with installation, you could have been having error messages with configuring the network or during the last part of installation, and these could probably be the error messages you're receiving. To solve the DHCP server error, make sure you enable the DHCP server of your VirtualBox network adapter, delete the VM and all its files and recreate it again. You can also consider restarting your machine as an option if the issue is with the poor network. And if you're facing the installation setup failure, one major thing could be that your hardware requirements cannot handle the VM. I mean, you could be having less space. And if you're updating from an older version of VirtualBox, you could be missing the extension package for VirtualBox. I will leave a detailed explanation in the description, so make sure you check it out. If it does not help, leave a comment. I will make a video for you. Alright, there you have it. Another fantastic journey together. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and want more, once again, don't hesitate to show your support. Hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you always in the loop. Remember, your likes, comments and shares motivate us to bring more of what you love. I will see you in the next video.